Bienvenue sur ma chaîne YouTube. Les Remote Learning Reminders. 1. Travaillez dans votre cahier ou sur un Google Doc. 2. Écrivez la date, le titre et les objectifs. 3. Regardez la vidéo YouTube. 4. Appuyez sur pause quand vous devez faire un exercice. Et corrigez vos exercices avec un stylo d'une autre couleur. 6. Nommez tous les exercices. 7. Une fois que vous avez fini, attachez votre travail, mettez en pièce jointe votre travail sur Google Classroom. Enfin, s'il y a un SEQ, faites-le. Les key instructions in French, écoutez, je répète, voilà la réponse, vérifiez vos réponses. Ok, so we are finishing the module about town, les villes. So we've seen the vocabulary about the weather, about the compass point, the places in town, the activity you can do in town, and the direction. So today we are doing the revision. And before going any further, you need to pause it and to complete the revision sheet, which has all the sentence builder that you've seen, and lots of little exercise, and that should take you about half an hour. This is why today you only have one video, but this one video is for the two lessons. So once you completed the revision sheet, then you can write in your book or complete your Google Doc template. The title is Révision, Unit 4, Unité 4, Where do you live? And the objective is of course to revise Unit 4 key vocabulary. Your main task is to match the start and the end of the sentence. So for example, if you see on number one, il y a, there is, you know that there is will be followed usually by what is there in your town, you know, there is, and the best possibility here would be there is or there are some restaurant and a stadium. So it would be il y a des restaurants et un stade. So one C goes together. Please press pause and have a go and try to do the challenge if you can. 3, 2, 1, voilà la réponse. Vérifiez vos réponses. Now, I would like you to do a little bit of revision about things there is and there isn't in town, because then next we're going to do a listening exercise. So please just match the numbers and letters of all these places in town, and of there is and there isn't any. Again, if you have time, do the challenge. Do you remember the meaning and the difference between le, la and les? Press pause and have a go. 3, 2, 1. Voilà les réponses. Vous pouvez vérifier vos réponses. Okay, so that was important that you revise this, because now we're going to do a listening activity. And this listening activity, we're going to listen to five people, and each time they're going to tell you what is in their town and what is not in their town. So you just need to write in English the answer. For example, let's do number one. Number one would be, il y a une piscine, mais il n'y a pas de patinoire. Je répète, il y a une piscine, mais il n'y a pas de patinoire. So, il y a une piscine. It means there is a swimming pool. So I expect you to write down swimming pool next to person one under there is. And il n'y a pas de patinoire means there isn't any ice rink. So I expect you to write down ice rink under there isn't for person one. Let's carry on for person two, three, four, and five. I always repeat the sentence twice. And if you want to, you can rewind and listen to it again. Person number two, person deux. Il y a un magasin, mais il n'y a pas de centre de loisirs. Je répète. Il y a un magasin, mais il n'y a pas de centre de loisirs. Sentence number three. Il y a un centre commercial, mais il n'y a pas de stade. Je répète, il y a un centre commercial, mais il n'y a pas de stade. Number 4, numéro 4. Il y a un marché, mais il n'y a pas de musée. Il y a un marché, mais il n'y a pas de musée. And finally, number 5. Il y a un château, mais il n'y a pas d'église. Il y a un château, mais il n'y a pas d'église. Ok, voilà les réponses. Here are the answers. Vérifiez vos réponses. 3, 2, 1. Now, it's another little listening exercise, but this time about opinions. So we've seen some opinions, but I wanted to remind them to you here. So you have the positive opinion and the negative opinion. The positive opinion, you can say c'est bien, it's good. C'est super, it's super. C'est intéressant, it's interesting. In the negative opinion about your town, you can say c'est ennuyeux, it's boring. Remember, you at the end, it sounds like you. C'est ennuyeux. C'est vraiment nul. It's really rubbish. So we've seen c'est nul, it's rubbish. I just added vraiment today. And we've seen petit, small. C'est petit would mean it is small. But I added trop, c'est trop petit mean it's too small. So just write down number 1 to 5 in your book or on your Google template. And you just need to pick which letter you hear, which opinion you hear. For example, for number 1, it is, somebody's asking the question, tu aimes ta ville? And the person answers, oui, à mon avis, c'est bien. Oui, à mon avis, c'est bien. So, the answer for number 1 would be A, because the person say, yes, in my opinion, it's good, c'est bien. So, 1A is the answer for number 1. Let's do number 2, 3, 4 and 5 now. Number 2. Tu aimes ton village? Non, je pense que c'est ennuyeux. Non, je pense que c'est ennuyeux. Pick your letter. Number 3. Aimes-tu ton village? Oui, à mon avis, c'est un endroit intéressant. Oui, à mon avis, c'est un endroit intéressant. Pick your letter. Number 4. Tu aimes ta ville? Oui, je pense que c'est super et intéressant. Oui, je pense que c'est super et intéressant. Pick your letter. This time there were 2 letters. And the last one, number 5. It's a little bit more complicated because people disagree with their opinion about the town. So there's up to 3 letters to write down here. Number 5. Aimes-tu ta ville? Non, à mon avis, c'est trop petit. C'est vraiment nul. Tu es d'accord? Ben non, je ne suis pas d'accord. Je pense que c'est bien. Je répète. Aimes-tu ta ville? Non, à mon avis, c'est trop petit. C'est vraiment nul. Tu es d'accord? Non, je ne suis pas d'accord. Je pense que c'est bien. So that's the end of the listening exercise. If you manage to do the challenge where the question asked, that would be good. But voilà les réponses. Here are the answers. Sorry. And the question was, tu aimes ta ville, which means, do you like your town? Okay. 3, 2, 1. Now you have a reading exercise. This reading exercise, this text seems very big, okay? But it's just gathering everything you learned so far about giving name, giving nationality, the age, to say where you live, to talk about the weather, to talk a little bit about the family, to see what's in the town, where is it with the direction, and what you can do in the town, okay? And opinion. So yes, it looks big, but lots of the vocabulary, you know it. The first thing I would like you to do is to read it and find the French for the expression which are under the text. So what is the French for often? For it doesn't rain, for big brother, for he doesn't live in my town, but everything is nearby also. I see the order, okay? So if you find, for example, big brother, you know that number one and two are before big brother. Okay? I let you read it and find the answers. Press pause and have a go. 3, 2, 1. Voilà la réponse. Okay, and now it's exactly the same text, but this time you have question about the text. So I let you reread the text. You might be a bit more confident by now with the meaning of this text. And let's see if you can answer this question in English. Press pause and have a go. 3, 2, 1. Voilà les réponses. And this is quite difficult exercise because it's a text that I'm going to read, and you have to write down the number 1 to 12 in your book or on your Google Doc, and you have to write the French word which is missing. So just have a go at it. If you find it too hard, don't worry about it. So let's see, let's do the first one together. J'habite à Villandreau, c'est un petit village. C'est un petit village. So the number one which is missing is petit. You see? So you just need to write one petit. Now I'm going to carry on reading the whole text, and I will read it another time. You can press pause anytime to give you the time to write down the word. À Villandreau, il y a un château. Il y a aussi un musée, il y a des restaurants et des cafés, mais il n'y a pas de patinoire. Il n'y a pas de centre commercial et il n'y a pas de centre de loisirs. So I stop at the word number 4. Now I'm going to line 5. On peut faire du canoë kayak, mais c'est tout. On peut faire du canoë-kayak, mais c'est tout. Line 6. Moi, je vais au café. J'aime ça. C'est bien. D'habitude, je joue au flipper avec mes copains. Line 8. Quelquefois, je vais au château. Line 9. Tous les week-ends, je vais au marché avec ma mère. Je déteste ça. Je n'aime pas habiter ici. À mon avis, c'est nul. C'est très ennuyeux. You can actually just rewind and re-listen to this text. And press pause and have a go. 3, 2, 1, voilà les réponses. Here are the answers. So you were missing château, patinoire, loisir, mais. On, by the way, mais c'est tout, you mean but that's all. J'aime ça, I like that. Je vais, I go, au marché, to the market, with my mother. I don't like living here. À mon avis, in my opinion, it's rubbish, it's very boring. And now you have some agreed. The purpose of this exercise is to do some writing. You can write an answer to the question which is in the middle by using some of the words which are all around it. So the question in the middle, quel temps fait-il aujourd'hui? If you forgot what it means, why is the weather like today? And you can use as many words as you want in order to make, to give an answer. The first word being on the top right corner with a capital letter, top left corner, sorry, aujourd'hui, today. So you can just pick any of these words to give me an answer. And your challenge is to include an opinion. So you can press pause and have a go. I won't give you any answer because it's up to you to make your own sentence. 3, 2, 1. You have exactly the same here with où habites-tu? Where do you live? You can use any of these words. Press pause and have a go. 3, 2, 1. Qu'est-ce qu'il y a dans ta ville? What is in your town? Press pause and have a go. 3, 2, 1. Qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire dans ta ville? What can we do in your town? Press pause and have a go. 3, 2, 1. And the last question, où sont les magasins? Where are the shops? Use any of these words to give me an answer. Press pause and have a go. 3, 2, 1. The delay dictation, I'm not actually going to give it to you because I realize it's quite a lot anyway. And we've done a big exercise before. But go you, and if you still have time, you can do a little bit of brain training and go on Quizlet and revise all the vocabulary. But with this PowerPoint, really, it gave you the opportunity to revise the vocabulary, to do some listening, to do some reading and some writing. So if you didn't have time to do everything, that's fine. But try to do a little bit of mix and match. Okay? Au revoir.